Huawei's Honor brand has been getting a lot of goodwill, thanks to the phones being great value for money. There's the Honor 7X, the Honor 9i, and now, the company has just launched its brand new Honor V10 smartphone in India, and it looks pretty darn good. So what are we waiting for? Let's get a quick look at the device, shall we? What's up guys, this is Rupesh from Beebom.com and this here is the new Honor V10, which seems like a pretty great device. So let's take a quick look at it. But before we do that, I think you should hit the bell icon to make sure you don't miss out on our awesome new videos. Now that you've done that, let's unbox this thing. The first thing that came into my mind when I took the V10 out of the box was, what a beauty. I mean, it looks beautiful and premium. But you really need to hold it to know what I'm talking about. The metal back is smooth and matte, which is just the combination I like. And the blue variant we have looks really, really cool. Plus, it has the fingerprint scanner on the front. Yes, on the front. I have no idea why other makers don't do this. In fact, I'm so used to rear fingerprint scanners on devices with 18:9 displays that initially I constantly searched the back of the V10 for the sensor. The display is 5.9 inches of 18:9 Full HD Plus LTPS IPS LCD, and it looks bright and beautiful. It's massive, but the low bezels make the phone pretty handy. Another notable thing is the display is LTPS, so we can expect lower power consumption than the regular IPS LCD displays. Overall, the Honor V10 does seem pretty sorted when it comes to the hardware. And yes, it does have the headphone jack, along with an infrared sensor. Under the hood, there's the company's very own high-silicon Kirin 970 processor with 6 gigs of RAM. And so far, the performance has been excellent, which is something I expected, considering this is Huawei's flagship processor we are talking about. When it comes to storage, the device has 128 gigs of onboard storage with a micro SD slot. Lastly, on the hardware front are the cameras, which on paper seem pretty high-end. The device has the 16 plus 20 megapixel f1.8 setup on the back with a ton of camera modes. Literally, a ton of camera modes. Of course, it has your favorite bokeh mode and there's the live photos like moving picture mode as well. But there are some really cool additional modes as well, which we'll be talking about in a full review. Here are a few shots we've taken, and in my short usage, the camera seems pretty decent, but I'd like to test it out more before forming a concrete opinion. The front 8 megapixel camera seems pretty impressive too. Well, those are the features which seem pretty standard when you consider phones these days, but Huawei has been marketing the V10 as quote unquote your first AI phone. Yes, the V10 is brimmed with artificial intelligence features that work with the device's built-in NPU, yeah, a neural processing unit. This means there are tons of smart features in Emotion UI 8.0. Apparently, everything in V10 software uses AI. According to Honor, the device runs smoother because AI makes the phone smoother by allocating services smartly. There's an AI-accelerated translator app, and even the camera is powered by AI, which is set to identify different scenes and objects and then adjust the camera settings accordingly. The camera detects text, animals, food, different lighting scenarios like moving objects, and then takes photos accordingly. Even the front camera apparently takes sharper portraits thanks to, you guessed it, AI's detection. The last feature that's powered by AI is the face unlock feature. Yeah, Face ID on the iPhone 10 has really started a trend. From the looks of it, the face recognition feature seems similar to the one we saw on the OnePlus 5T, but we'll be putting face unlock on the V10 through tests to see if it is different or any better. Apart from these software features, the EMUI 8.0 in V10 is feature-packed. App locker, dual apps, game mode, ultra-power saving mode, night mode, themes, just say it and it's here. Plus, I really like the fact that the device comes with Oreo out of the box, which is something not a lot of device can boast of. Good job there, Honor. Another area where Honor seems to have done a great job is the battery. The V10 includes a 3750mAh battery with Honor's supercharged tech, which seems pretty similar to OnePlus's dash charging tech. And if that's true, it's pretty impressive. Now I know what you're thinking. The View 10 seems like a pretty great device, right? Well, I think so too. But I'd say it's too early to judge, especially when we don't even know the price of the phone. Yes, Honor hasn't revealed the price of the View 10, but the company is said to be aiming at the OnePlus 5T. And if they are, I'd say OnePlus 5T finally has a worthy competitor. The View 10 does seem like a pretty capable device, and a device that can evenly match the OnePlus 5T. And we will be putting it to test against the OnePlus 5T in a full review. So stay tuned for that. Also, give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends if you enjoyed it. Comment down below if you have any questions related to the View 10. And subscribe to our channel for more amazing tech videos. Well, that's me signing off. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.